Hey everyone, welcome to Soap Trend. We hope that everybody is doing well. We have some shocking news to share with you all in today's video from our favorite TV series When Caught the Heart. The creator of When Caught the Heart, Brian Bird, shares a devastating loss. That is the loss of Janet Oak's husband, Dr. Edward Lawrence Oak, as he is no more with us today. Do watch this video till the end to know everything. Brian Bird, the executive producer of our favorite TV series When Caught the Heart, took to Facebook to share devastating news. The news of the demise of Janet Oak's husband. He wrote, "Hearties, as some of you may have heard on January 3, our beloved Janet Oak lost her husband of 64 years, Dr. Edward Lawrence Oak, after his long battle with cancer. While Janet may have been more in the spotlight because of her prolific literary career, Edward was an accomplished pastor, theologian, and PhD educator for half a century, all the while loving and supporting his wife, 4 children, 16 grandchildren, and 17 great-grandchildren. As we would expect from the author of When Caught the Heart and so many other books filled with the values of faith, love, and hope, Janet served as his main hospice caregiver for the last several months of his life and was by his side when he passed into eternity. And some of you may remember that Edward was by Janet's side at our third Hearties family reunion in Vancouver in 2017 and was so impressed by the love Hearties have for both Janet and the world and TV shows inspired by her beautiful books. And she asked me to pass along her love and gratitude to the Hearties community for their love and support of her and Edward all these years. All of us from Soap Trend would like to take a moment of silence to remember Dr. Edward Lawrence Oak." Dr. Edward Lawrence Oak was born in Henna, Alberta on May 7, 1935 to Harold and Mabel Oak. He passed away on January 3, 2022, eagerly anticipating a reunion with his parents, his sister Alta Mae Hannah, infant son Brian Edward, and infant granddaughter Amanda Janet, as well as many family members, fellow workers, and dear friends. Edward was a preschooler when his family moved to Disbury, where his father operated the International Harvester dealership. His mother spent a number of years as an elementary school teacher. Edward enjoyed Boy Scouts, playing hockey, summer Bible camp, and his woodworking shop. His daughter Laurel and 7 granddaughters are proud of the individually designed cedar chests. He also enjoyed music, being a vocalist in choirs, male quartets, and as a soloist. And having had several years of training, he was a good pianist. He graduated from Mountain View Bible College in Disbury in 1957 and shortly after married fellow graduate Janice Steves. They left for Bethel College in Indiana, where he continued his graduate work. He followed up with a master's degree at Goshen Seminary and later received his PhD in Higher Education Administration at Andrews University in Michigan. Edward pastored churches in Montgomery and Edmonton before being appointed as the president of MBBC in 1963. From then on, he spent his years in Christian Higher Education and Bethel College, Indiana, and Rocky Mountain College in Calgary. His primary focus was New Testament and Greek. It was especially meaningful for him to help young people learn and grow in their Christian faith. He loved the interaction with his many students, and they in turn often dubbed him their favorite professor. Teasingly, he was known as the college cupid. He kept a keen eye on student romances, officiating in a number of marriage unions. Dr. Edward Lawrence Oak was also known as the girl runner opponent, being challenged by the fastest female sprint racer year by year. Even though they came prepared with proper track shoes and he came directly from his office in suit and oxfords, he never lost a race. In the summer, he loved being a part of James River Bible Camp, where he taught the camping skills he had learned from his scoutmaster, Peter Walden. However, in spite of his knowledge and caution, He still bore the scar from a mishap with a hatchet that resulted in some stitches and a lot of good-natured teaching. But today, Dr. Oak is no longer with us. He will be deeply missed by his wife Janet, three sons and their spouses, Terry and Barbara, Lavan and Monica, Lern and Deb, daughter Laurel Logan and former son-in-law Marvin Logan, 16 grandchildren, soon to be 17 great-grandchildren, many extended family members and former ministering co-workers, students and friends. So this much for today's video. We hope you liked it. We will deliver more news of Uncaused the Heart as it comes in. We will have all the warning Uncaused the Heart spoilers, news and updates you're looking for. So visit us regularly. Thank you for checking this video out. We will see each other very soon with another video. If you like this video, give us a like and subscribe to our channel for new videos every day. If you have anything to say, do let us know in the comment section below. We'll make sure to reply to your comments.